Hello kids, let's continue with the chapter 2, whole numbers. We are going to learn properties of whole numbers. Here the first property is closure property. Now in closure property, we have to add two whole numbers and we'll see what will be the sum of this addition. For example, 5 plus 9. Now 5 is a whole number, we are adding 9 to it, 9 is also a whole number and the answer is 14. 14 is a sum of 5 and 9, which is also a whole number. One more example, that is 11 plus 27. Now here 11 and 27 both are whole numbers and its sum means its answer is 38, which is also a whole number. So here we can derive or we can understand that the sum of every pair of whole numbers we added is a whole number. This is true for all whole numbers. So the sum of two whole numbers is a whole number. This is called the closure property of addition of whole numbers. We say that the whole numbers are closed under addition. That is, if A and B are two whole numbers, then A plus B is a whole number. Here, the small a and small b are the variables. Here, variable means they can have any value. So, for A, you can consider any number, any whole number. For B also, you can consider any whole number. So, when you add any two whole numbers, its answer is also a whole number, which is called closure property. Let's see now what will happen when we multiply two whole numbers. Here are few examples. The first example is 8 multiplied by 12. The answer is 96. Now 96 is the product of the two whole numbers and 96 itself is a whole number. The same way, if you see 23 multiplied by 8. The answer is 184. So here also the product of two whole number is also a whole number. So that we can see that product of two whole numbers taken here is also a whole number. So here we can conclude that the whole numbers are closed under multiplication. That is, if A and B are two whole numbers and A multiplied by B is equals to C. So here A can carry any whole number, B also can be any whole number and C is the product of two whole numbers. Here so is also a whole number. Let's see now when are the whole numbers are closed for subtraction and division? Let us see few examples. In subtraction, if you see 15 minus 8, the answer is 7, which is a whole number. But in the same way, if you see another example, that is 18 minus 20, is it a whole number? No, it is not a whole number. This operation will not give you a whole number. Same way, if you see in division, 48 divided by 4 is equals to 12. Now here the answer 12 is a whole number. But in other case, if you see 5 divided by 3, and answer is 5 upon 3 or else it can be in a decimal number, which is not a whole number. Thus the whole numbers are not closed under subtraction and division. Let us see now the new property, or the second property, commutative property. Now there is one question that when we add two whole numbers, does it matter in which order we add them? Let's see some examples. Now here if you see that 12 plus 9 is equals to 21. If I simply change the order of 12 and 9, if instead of 12 plus 9, if I do 9 plus 12, it will give me the same answer. Let's see one more example. Here, I'm adding 11 and 36. The answer is 47. If I change the order of 36 and 11, so instead of 11 plus 36, if I do 36 plus 11, will give me the same answer, which is 47. So here you can say that we can take that the sum of two whole numbers remains the same, even you change the order of the whole numbers. So the whole numbers are commutative under addition. Thus, for any two whole numbers, that is A and B, so if I do A plus B is equals to, if I do B plus A, means if I do A plus B or B plus A, both of them's answer will remain the same. Let us now check if this property is true for multiplication also or not. So let's see a few examples here. That 7 multiplied by 5 is 35, and 5 multiplied by 7 is also a 35. So here if you see that I have changed the sequence of 7 and 5, still the product of them remains the same. Let's see one more example, which is 15 multiplied by 6. The product is 90. And now 6 multiplied by 15 is also gives us the product 90. So here we can say that the product of two whole number is the same even if the order is changed. So here we can say that the whole numbers are commutative under multiplication. Thus, for any two whole numbers, A and B, so A multiplied by B or B multiplied by A, will remain the same. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe. We'll meet you soon with one more.